In this video, we insert a dielectric, in other words, an insulator, between the plates of a charged parallel plate capacitor, and we use this guy to introduce the idea of a dielectric constant and learn how to calculate the induced electric field and induced surface charge density. Then we're going to take a look at how the dielectric affects capacitance and how to phrase some of these results in terms of permittivity. So finally, to wrap things up at the end, we're going to work an example that summarizes most of our results. So we start with a capacitor that's been charged up with a battery and then disconnected. So the charge on the plates is going to be fixed for the remainder of the discussion. And remember, the electric field inside of a parallel plate capacitor is uniform and points from the positive plate to the negative plate. And we're going to call that guy E naught. So notice in our description down here, I said that E naught is the original field due to the charge density sigma on the plates. So just to clarify, that sigma is normally used to represent an area charge density. So that's going to be measured in coulombs per square meter spread out along the plate. Now recall from our prior discussions on dielectric materials that exposure to an electric field is going to polarize the dielectric. So this results in a net positive surface charge density on the bottom surface of this dielectric and a negative surface charge density on the top surface of this dielectric. And that's essentially due to the microscopic stretching of the electron clouds around the atoms in this insulating material. Just keep in mind the electrons can't move over large distances here. This is really just a warping of the electron orbits. So the net result of that polarization is a small positive surface charge density on that lower surface and a small negative surface charge density on the upper surface. But we quickly realized that these induced surface charges on the insulating material produce an electric field of their own. And that, of course, points from positive to negative. It's going to be the same thing as a parallel plate capacitor field, except using the induced surface charges as the charges for the plates. And we're going to notate that as E sub N for induced. So we say En is the induced field due to the charge density sigma N, so the induced surface charge density on the dielectric material itself. So the first thing we want to do is look at a couple key results for how the presence of a dielectric is going to affect the electric field inside this capacitor. And just by looking at the geometry of this situation, we see that the induced field is going to reduce the overall field inside the capacitor because it's pointing in the opposite direction to the original field from the charged conducting plates. So when we vector add those two fields, we get a smaller result. Now this can be basically taken as a definition of dielectric constant. The resulting field E inside the capacitor is equal to E naught divided by kappa, where kappa is the dielectric constant. So we knew the field had to be reduced in there, and we define the effectiveness of this dielectric material based on the factor that it reduces the field by. So next, remember those electric fields are going to add vectorially in between the plates. And we have our original field pointing downward, that's E naught, our induced field pointing upward. So we can say their magnitudes subtract to give us the net electric field, which we call E. But now we can use the fact that the net electric field is equal to E naught divided by the dielectric constant. So we write E naught over kappa is equal to E naught minus E induced. Now this is going to allow us to solve for an explicit expression for the induced electric field. So we add En to both sides, we subtract E naught over kappa, and we factor an E naught out of that expression. This gives us an expression for the induced electric field between the plates. So the induced electric field turns out to be E naught, that's the original electric field from the charges on the plates of the capacitor, times the quantity 1 minus 1 over the dielectric constant. And that's the first formula in this video that's important enough to get a box around it. So second, we want to be able to actually calculate the induced charge density on the surface of that insulating material. And just as a reminder, remember we have a surface charge density on the charged conducting plates of this capacitor. That's plus sigma at the top and minus sigma at the bottom. And then our induced charges are plus sigma induced at the bottom and minus sigma induced at the top. So what we're after here is an expression for the induced surface charge in terms of the original surface charge on the conducting plates. So here's where we're going to start. We have a little reminder of how to calculate the electric field inside a parallel plate capacitor when you know the surface charge density. And this result came from applying Gauss's law. We got E naught is equal to sigma over epsilon zero, where epsilon zero is the permittivity of free space. Well, we can extend this result to the electric field generated by the induced charge separation on the dielectric. In other words, we're just treating those induced charges on the dielectric slab as the plates of its own parallel plate capacitor, and we use the same result from Gauss's law. So this time we say the magnitude of the induced electric field is given by the induced surface charge density over the permittivity of free space epsilon zero. So this gives us a way to write down the induced surface charge density as epsilon zero times E induced. But in our previous section, we just figured out how to solve for E induced. That's just E naught times the quantity 1 minus 1 over the dielectric constant. Now at this point, we see an epsilon zero E naught out in front, and we realize we can just go back to our original field inside the capacitor and write sigma equals epsilon zero E naught, where sigma is the charge density on the capacitor plates. So now we arrive at an expression for the induced area charge density on the surfaces of this dielectric slab. So that's sigma times the quantity 1 minus 1 over kappa. And that's our second equation that's important enough to live in a box. Next, we need a quick note on how the presence of a dielectric is going to affect the capacitance. So remember, capacitance is defined to be charge per volt, or Q over V. And our original capacitance of this guy could be written as Q divided by V naught, where V naught is the original voltage that we charge it up to with our battery. But remember, the original potential difference between these plates before we inserted the dielectric between them would have been given by E naught times D. So that's actually a path integral of electric field, but with electric field being constant, it turns into a simple product, E naught times D. So once we put the dielectric in there, it reduces the electric field by a factor of kappa, and therefore the voltage is going to reduce by a factor of kappa as well. So our new voltage between these plates is going to be V naught divided by kappa. Now remember, the charge on the plates is not changing here, so we can calculate our new capacitance by just subbing in our new voltage once we put the dielectric between these plates. Our voltage was reduced by a factor of kappa, and then we just do a little bit of algebra here, and we realize that our new capacitance is kappa times the original capacitance. So knowing that dielectric constants are greater than one, what we figured out here is that putting a dielectric between the plates of a capacitor actually increases the capacitance, and that formula lives in a box as well. And just one more note on capacitance here. Remember, the way we compute capacitance based on the geometry of a parallel plate capacitor is that it was epsilon zero times A over D. Well, now if we have a dielectric between the plates, that gets multiplied by a factor of kappa, and we get a formula for capacitance, kappa epsilon zero A over D. So the final thing we're going to introduce here is the idea of permittivity. Now remember, epsilon zero, we've been calling that the permittivity of free space for a long time now, but now we're going to define permittivity in general as dielectric constant multiplying the permittivity of free space. So the dielectric constant for empty space is just one, and we get the permittivity of free space. But when there's some kind of insulating material around, we're going to sub in that value of kappa to get a new value of permittivity. The whole point of this is that it simplifies a lot of expressions that we deal with when we're working in the presence of a dielectric. So here's one example. We just saw that capacitance could be computed as kappa epsilon zero A over D. Well, we just replaced the kappa epsilon zero with an epsilon for permittivity, and it just produces an analogous formula to our original capacitor formula, just replacing an epsilon zero with an epsilon. We can also do the same thing for the electric field between the plates of this capacitor with the dielectric present. Remember, that's going to be E naught divided by kappa, but E naught can be related to the area charge density on the plates as sigma over epsilon zero. And again, we discover a kappa epsilon zero in that denominator, and we simply replace it with an epsilon standing for the permittivity of this dielectric material. So this produces the simple formula sigma over epsilon for the electric field between the plates of a capacitor when there's a dielectric between those plates. Okay, just a quick review. Remember, the electric field between the plates of this capacitor is reduced when we put a dielectric in there. That's because the induced electric field points opposite to the original electric field and partially cancels it out. And we defined dielectric constant by this relationship. We said the net resulting field is equal to the original field divided by the dielectric constant kappa. So then we derived an expression for computing the induced electric field due to the charge separation on the dielectric. That's given by original electric field times the quantity 1 minus 1 over kappa. We then found a way of computing the surface charge density on the dielectric material, and that's given by the surface charge density on the capacitor plates times that same factor, 1 minus 1 over kappa. Then we figured out the presence of a dielectric is going to increase the capacitance by a factor of kappa. So we get kappa times C naught, or subbing in some details about the geometry of the capacitor, kappa epsilon zero A over D. Finally, and this is really just a stylistic decision, we decided to replace kappa epsilon zero with epsilon, and we call that the permittivity of that particular dielectric material. This allows us to simplify some of the formulas we're deriving, and they become analogous to formulas that we previously found when there were no dielectrics present. So the capacitance is going to be given by epsilon A over D. The electric field between the plates of this capacitor is given by sigma over epsilon, where sigma is the surface charge density on the original conductive capacitor plates, and epsilon is the permittivity of the dielectric material. So this example isn't comprehensive, but it is a good review of most of the ideas that we covered in this video. We're told that we have a parallel plate capacitor with two square plates of side length 20 centimeters and a separation distance of 0.8 centimeters between them. We initially charge this thing up to 12 volts with a battery and then disconnect it. Now, to be clear, in the initial state, there is no dielectric between those plates. It's just a vacuum in there. And then when we insert a dielectric material, the potential difference drops to 2.4 volts. Keep in mind that with a capacitor charged up by a battery and then disconnected, the total charge is fixed on the plates. All right, so our first question is to find the original capacitance of this thing. And so we're using our formula that tells us how to find the capacitance based on the geometry of the capacitor. So that's going to be epsilon zero A over D. Remember, in the initial state, it's just a vacuum between those plates. So now we sub in the permittivity of free space. That's about 8.85 times 10 to the negative 12 farads per meter. And then we need the area of the plates, and we need to have this in SI units. So it's going to be 0.2 meters squared for the area of a plate, and then divided by the plate's separation distance. Again, we need to put that in meters. So that's 0.008 meters. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 4.425 times 10 to the negative 11th farads. Next, we're going to find the charge on the plates. So remember, the definition of capacitance is charge per volt, or Q over V. And that means we can find the charge by taking C times V. Well, we just found the capacitance in part A. So all we have to do is sub in 4.425 times 10 to the negative 11th farads for the capacitance, and we had this thing charged up to 12 volts before we introduced the dielectric. And this gives us 5.31 times 10 to the negative 10th coulombs. So next we're asked to find the dielectric constant. And what we notice here is that when we introduced the dielectric, it cut the voltage from 12 volts all the way down to 2.4. Now remember that potential difference, or voltage, is proportional to the size of the electric field, because it's computed just as E times D. So we can just figure out the factor by which the voltage was cut down here. That was 12 volts originally, and then 2.4 volts in the final state. So our new voltage is 1/5 the size of the original voltage, and that means the electric field must be 1/5 the size of the original electric field, which means our dielectric constant must be 5. Now, if you want an argument that's a little more formal than that, we can just say, okay, the potential difference is E times D. And this is after putting the dielectric in. And then we remember that E between the plates with a dielectric is just E naught divided by kappa. And that E naught times D is the original voltage between the plates. So we call that V naught, and that's 12 for us in this case. And then we can solve for kappa and say the kappa is V naught divided by V, which is 12 divided by 2.4 again. The dielectric constant turns out to be 5. Okay, and finally, we're trying to find the induced charge density. So we have a little formula for this, that it's equal to the area charge density on the charged plates of the capacitor times this factor, 1 over 1 minus kappa. So we need to compute the original surface charge density on the plates of the capacitor, and that's going to be the total charge. Remember, that was 5.31 times 10 to the negative 10 coulombs divided by the area that it was spread over. So remember, area charge density is measured in coulombs per square meter. So we're dividing by the area this is spread over. That's 0.2 meters all squared. And then we have to multiply this by 1 minus 1 over 5. And when I run the numbers on this, I get about 1.06 times 10 to the negative 8th coulombs per square meter. In the next video, we learn how to rework the electric field energy density in the presence of a dielectric. I'll post a link to that video at the upper left of the end screen, and I'll see you there.